It's the man of the moment. It's Thomas Sadoski from Reasons to be Pretty, nominated for the Drama Desk Award for Best Actor in a Play. Congratulations, man. You were beyond awesome as far as I'm concerned. And I'm a voting member. So
thank you.
That's why he's talking to me. But that's okay. It's okay.
Not
I'm
at all.
To be
thank you.
To you.
Anybody who's wearing this, I'm talking to
well,
them.
Black
Come
and
on.
White,
look,
it goes
look
together.
At you. You know, we're like walking the ebony and ivory thing right now. We're
right,
doing good.
Right. You were so awesome in that
thank
show.
Thank you, man. Thank
nominated
you.
Nominated also for an Outer Critics Circle.
I am.
You know, what's next? The Tony on Tuesday morning?
You know what? I can't. I'm not going to jinx myself. I'm so superstitious about that stuff. But I would say that my mom would be really proud.
Well, I'm really proud to have you here today and to tell you how much I loved your performance.
I really
you
appreciate
were
that. Thank
awesome.
You. Thank you.
I'm using all these teeny bopper words because, like, that's the language the play by Neil La Bute is written in, which is also nominated for Best Play. So
it
you
is.
Have to speak about that because he's not here.
No, Neil is not here, but I know.
Tell the viewers about your part and about the play.
Well, in terms of the show, I mean, it's a departure for Neil. You know, Neil tends to write these plays that kind of end a little bit nihilistically. They kind of end with a little bit of a darkened view of humanity, and I think in this and in this situation, Neil decided he was going to write a play about a guy whose time had come to grow up, and who was having a really hard time with it, but who eventually makes a tough decision and does it. And that's the character that I'm playing, the character of Greg.
I'm real like blue collar people.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. These are folks. You know, it takes place in the suburbs outside Chicago, working people. You know, which is my background, and it's a world that I'm not unfamiliar with. You know, and
were you in the play all the way through?
I started it downtown at the Lortel, yeah, and brought
with
it.
Pablo
brought
it, Schreiber
with
also
Pablo,
nominated.
Yep.
He
also
was in the other part. I
yep.
was going, what part did he get nominated? It was the other part?
Yep,
right?
Yep. Yes, he was. Yeah, yeah.
And we're hoping he's going to be here today.
He was around here a little while ago.
Oh, okay.
I know that Pobs is, you know. I don't know where he was. He was soaking wet though. It was raining. Poor guy.
It's raining out.
Yeah, it's terrible. Sorry. That's why I'm like all wet and nasty and smell a little bit like a wet dog.
No, it's fine, really. It's really fine. And your performance was so sensitive so multi-layered and did you just audition for this? I don't know your work previously.
I did. Well, you know, I've been banging around off Broadway for a long time. And I did actually audition for it. Terry and I had sort of known each other.
Terry Kinney,
our director, yeah.
He was also nominated.
He was also nominated, yep. Thankfully, he should be. He's an extraordinary director and really one of the better ones I've ever worked with in terms of speaking to actors. And he did a phenomenal job with this group. Not only this group uptown, but the group downtown as well. And Terry is, you know, I owe so much of this to him. So.
And Marin Ireland, who I know.
Goddess.
Piper Perabo.
A goddess. I mean, these really just extraordinary women that I have an opportunity to work with. And half over the last year, you know, I mean, walking in between the downtown version of this and the uptown version of this, I sandwiched in Becky Shaw at second stage and got a chance to work with Emily Burgle.
And that's been nominated for Best Play, too.
It has,
yeah.
God. Annie Parise and Kelly Bishop. So it's been a year for me of working with extraordinary women and doing some Neil La Bute. So there's the...
You're Broadway's new hot leading man, Thomas Sadoski, profiled in the New York Times, I think.
That was me.
My God. Yeah. Congratulations.
Thank you, man. Thank you very much.
What was that like?
You know,
did they follow you around for days
they
and
didn't,
bother you?
They didn't. No, it was actually really lovely. Pat Healy came up to the dressing room and just kind of we sat and we had a really lovely conversation for about an hour and a half. And
that was it.
That was about it. Yeah.
When I wrote, I've written for the New York Times, and when I wrote for them, I was following the person I was writing about around for 6 months. They kept sending me back and getting more.
Six
and more.
Months?
Yeah.
How long did your column end up being?
The same as your article, you know.
Six
they do
months
that.
For that. That's incredible.
Well, the research. It was on something. Well, that's another program. You guys can go look that up on YouTube. But anyway, well, I'm on YouTube now, too, on 34 million hits.
Congratulations. Susan Boyle.
Yeah, or 30. Yes. Right, I am Susan Boyle, really.
You're the Susan Boyle of New York. Congratulations.
Right. You're not the first person. My therapist said that to me, too. Hey, Jim. I didn't know where to put it, but I'm hugely flattered. I only wish I had as many hits as she's got. But you're the hit of Broadway right now, and all these wonderful things are going to come to you. And, you know, thank you.
Thank you
for that beautiful performance.
Thank you very much.
Thomas Sadoski here today on the Stephen Holt Show. You can text message and vote. No, that's American Idol. Wait a minute. That's another program. By coming to the Stephen Holt channel on YouTube, you've already voted.
Indeed.
For Thomas Sadoski.
Keep voting. 35 million. Let's go.
Okay. All right. All right.
Stephen, thank you, man.
Thank you, man.